So today we are starting a new topic, triangulation of manifolds. Recall, triangulation of any topological space just means that we have a simplicial complex K such that the geometric realization of the simplicial complex K denoted by mod K is homeomorphic to the topological space given. Okay, so that means that's a triangulation. The homeomorphism will be called a triangulation, whatever you want to say. If such a thing exists, then the space is called triangulable. Okay, so we are going to study triangulated manifolds. So in particular, it will have the properties of a simplicial complex as well. So let us begin, make a beginning with the study of local homology of triangulated manifolds. So local homology of any simplicial complex, first of all. Then we will go back to that it is a triangulation of a manifold and then strengthen those results. So as general as we can speak, what is happening to the homology, local homology of any simplicial complex? Okay, so it is first lemma here. Let K be any simplicial complex and F be any face in it. Let X belong to the interior of F. That is a point in the interior of mod F. So this is a geometric realization. Mod F just means all summation Ti, Vi, where Vi's are vertices of F. Okay, if all the Ti's are positive, that is element in the interior. Then the homology statement is the following. Hi of the relative pair mod k comma mod k minus x, you throw away that point, the relative homology of this one is the same thing as the hi twiddle of the reduced homology of the link of f. Okay, but the dimension is reduced, which is hi minus dimension of f minus 1. So this is the statement. So recall that for any simplex F in K, the open star little st of F is an open subset of mod K. How was it defined? It is the union of all simplexes F union G, okay, open. So open part of that, where F union G, it must be a simplex. Then you take F union G, the open part of that, and take the union of all that. So that is called the open star of F. It is almost similar to when F is a single point, it is star of V we have defined. So that is generalized to this one. Okay, and automatically it will be an open subset of mod K itself. Okay. But therefore, we can apply this theorem 3.7, which is the excision theorem. Okay. Whenever you have two open sets covering the entire thing, the two open sets are will be excisive couples. The star of F, this is the closed star of F, modulo mod K minus X, this is an excisive couple. Okay. Both of them are, this is a star of F is not a closed set, but open star of F, it contains interior of that, interior of this one, they cover it. That's why this is an excisive couple. Okay. So in the X, which is equal to star of f union x minus x. Union of that, that's where, oh, capsid cover means what? This is not the whole space, right? Star of f union k minus x, okay? By excision theorem, 3.6, okay, sorry, h, star of f union k minus x is the whole of x, because star, this, whatever you have thrown away, x is already inside star of f. By excision theorem, k to k minus a single point is the same thing as star of f intersection with k minus x, which is star of f minus x. So this hi is isomorphic to the hi of this one. It is like x comma a, homology is isomorphic to b comma a intersection b. If a and b are the entire, a and b is an excessive couple. Okay, so this is isomorphic to this one. So what we want to try, we are trying to that, we are estimating this left hand side. So the first step is that this whatever is given at left hand side here is hi of star of x minus x. So this is what we mean by localizing. Instead of the whole complex k, you have come just around, you know, the neighborhood of f here. So both the relative things have come to neighborhood of f here. So that is the first step. So let us see further why it is just the homology of the link, okay? Recall that we have also proved that star of f minus a single point in the interior of f, this will contain link of f join with b boundary of f, modulus of that as a deformation retract. From x, you can radially push it out to link of f star boundary of f. This star is the join of these two things. That is a subcomplex. So it is similar to the picture wherein you have a disk and a point in the interior removed. So that is deformation retracts to the boundary sphere. So it is similar to that. So this we have proved in part one. Okay, this is not a very difficult thing. So here we will have to assume that one now. Okay. Therefore, hi of star of f, link of f star b of f. So this is the deformation retract of this one, the second part. Okay, therefore, I can replace this one by this one, only the boundary. So this is again similar to dn comma sn minus 1 homology, same thing as dn comma dn minus 0. It's similar to that. Okay, but you can't use that result. You have to use this result, namely star of f minus x is deforms to this subset, this subset of this one anyway. Okay, let us denote by k the dimension of f. Okay, that means there are k plus 1 elements in k plus 1 vertices in f. Okay, since star of f, star of anything is contractible. Okay, it's actually a convex subset inside mod k. So this is contractible. What we have is, in the homology exact sequence of this pair, hi of this one will be 0, hi of this one will come, next one, the next thing will be again hi minus 1 of this one will come, then hi of this one will come. So every term, three terms, it will be 0, the two terms will be isomorphic. So that is what happens, namely hi of star of f to link of boundary of f, this one, which is isomorphic, this one is isomorphic to hi minus 1 of the link of this one, the second part. Because the next term will be hi minus 1 of star of f, that is 0. The previous term will be also hi of star of f, that is also 0. So this is the connecting homomorphism. That is an isomorphism. Okay, I think we used to have this as delta, So you can use it delta here, okay, doesn't matter. So, but this is what? This boundary of a simplex, it is homeomorphic to a sphere. F is a K-simplex, so its boundary is homeomorphic to a sphere, okay? So it is modulus of this, the same thing as, I mean, the underlying topological space is same thing as link of F modulus joined with SK minus 1. Okay. But what is the join with SK minus 1? It is the iterated suspension. Join with S naught is the suspension. With S1 is a suspension of suspension and so on. So you have to suspend K times. Okay, that's a dimension of K. By suspension isomorphism, you keep coming down hi minus 1 to hi minus 1 minus dimension of F, and then you have just the link of F. The suspension isomorphism starts from here, and suspend it, the homology dimension increases. Okay, use that one iteratively. K times you get hi total of 1 minus I minus 1 minus dimension of F. Okay. So this establishes this isomorphism. So this is an elementary result which we will be using later on. Now let us make a definition. Take any simplicial complex, then we say it is pure of dimension. We have done this in the case of CW complexes. It is similar to that. Pure of dimension n means each simplex in K is a face of an n simplex. In other words, all maximal simplexes are of the same dimension n. Okay, so that is the meaning of pure. This is just some terminology. In other words, K is pure of dimension n if and only if every maximal simplex in K is of dimension n. So this could be taken as a definition also. For a topological manifold, now let us start with a manifold. Manifold with or without boundary. So let us take without boundary. Given any point x in x, we can choose a neighborhood u of x homeomorphic to Rn. If it is a boundary, then we would have done homeomorphic to Hn minus half, Hn, right, half space. So if it is an interior point all the time, namely it is man, so without boundary, then you have this one. By excision, it follows that Hi of x minus x, x comma x minus x, is Hi of u comma u minus x, because u comma r, u comma x minus x, is an excessive couple. Okay, use that. But u comma u minus x is homeomorphic to the pair Rn comma Rn minus 0. This is a homeomorphism. X goes to 0, you can use that one, right? You can have such a chart. So under the homeomorphism, x goes to 0, so you can throw away that one. So these two are the same. Okay. Now combine this with the lemma. What happens? In the lemma, what we have proved, for points inside a mod F, okay, Hi here, you see, is Hi total of I minus dimension of F minus 1, link of this one, right? So you can X minus X, this X is a not an arbitrary point, but entire F, it has this happens, it has happens this way. So if you use this property, so what we get? We immediately get the following results now. Let X be a connected compact topological N-manifold without boundary. I want to emphasize that. K be a simplicial complex such that mod K is X. That is, K is a triangulation of X. Then the following holds. What happens? For all non-empty faces F of K, we have एच आई ट्विडल ऑफ लिंक ऑफ एफ इज जीरो फॉर आई लेस देन डायमेंशन ऑफ द लिंक ऑफ एफ एंड व्हेन डायमेंशन इज इक्वल टू एफ ओके व्हेन आई इज इक्वल डायमेंशन देन इट इज आइसोमॉर्फिक टू जेड फॉर आई इक्वल डायमेंशन ऑफ द लिंक दैट इज लिंक ऑफ एफ इज ए होमोलॉजी स्फीयर होमोलॉजी स्फीयर मीन्स वॉट द sphere has some homology, namely all the homologies except the nth homology is zero, right? The reduced homology. So similar thing is happening. Homology sphere of dimension equal to dimension of the link. Okay, this is true for the links. We know that the boundary of a simplex is actually a sphere, but the links of a triangulated manifold in the links are spheres of corresponding dimension, namely dimensions of link of F. Whatever it is, that it is like a homology sphere. Okay? So this follows immediately here. Take F and X. So this being a manifold, okay? Look at here. This theorem. This being a manifold, I can replace mod k by x. This is the homology of the sphere. Okay. It is hi of rn, rn minus 0, which is same thing as hi minus 1 of sn minus 1, if n is dimension. So only I equal to n minus 1, it is infinite cyclic, otherwise it is 0. Right? So that's what I'm using here now in the first part here. Everywhere else it is zero. When I equal to dimension of the link, it is that if I equal to this one. Okay, the second part, K must be pure of dimension N. Every simplex must be contained in a N simplex. So this is like a invariance of domain which follows very easily here. Okay. Start with a topological manifold. Okay. Every simple, the largest simplex is everywhere. Is of the same dimension n. Okay. The third statement is this is somewhat non-trivial. We need some proof. Every n minus 1 simplex of K occurs as a face of exactly two simplexes. The fourth statement is given any two simplexes, sigma and tau, inside X, inside K, there is a chain of simplexes, N simplexes, connecting sigma and tau. What is the meaning of this? This is like a path. Remember, a connected simplicial complex from one vertex to another vertex, there is a path of edges. Through edges only you can go through. Similarly here, through simplexes you can go. So what is the meaning of this? So you have a sequence of simplexes S1, S2, SK. S1 is tau, sigma, and SK is tau. What happens to SI intersection SI plus 1 consecutive ones? That is exactly one N minus 1 phase. Both SI and SI plus 1 are N simplexes. One of the common phase, okay, exactly one common phase is there for both of them. So that is a edge sequence. From any simplex to any other simplex, you can go through a edge, you can go through a sequence of n simplexes like this, a path of n simplexes like this. Okay, so these three and four are new to here. So I will let us go through that one. The first one is immediate from lemma 6.8. That's what I already have proved. Okay. Dimension of link, you should know, is exactly equal to n minus dimension of f minus 1. In other words, if you take a vertex in an n simplex, its link is nothing but the boundary of f, which is n minus 1. Okay, like that. So whatever dimension of the total dimension minus the link dimension is equal to dimension of f plus 1. Or you can say n minus dimension of f minus 1 is a dimension of thing. So you substitute this one there in the earlier statement, statement 1 follows. Okay, second statement is what? Second statement here is k is pure of dimension n. Okay, so how do we prove that? If f is a maximal simplex, then interior of f is an open set. Okay, hence for x inside mod f, inside in the interior of f, x minus x and f, this is an excessive couple. Also, the boundary of any simplex is a strong deformation retract of mod f minus the single point. This is we have been using several times because mod f is nothing but homeomorphic to the closed disk. Okay, therefore, we have hi of x, x minus x, you can write, rewrite it in a different way, hi of f, f minus x. That is hi minus 1 of f minus x by exact sequence, homology exact sequence, because mod f is contractible. Okay, so mod f minus x is nothing but homotopy equivalent to the boundary of f. So I can replace this one by boundary of f here, hi minus 1 of boundary of f. So this means the boundary of f is a homology n minus 1 sphere, because that is what this homology is, hi of x minus x is. It is same thing as hi of Rn minus 0. Therefore, f must be n simplex. Okay. I started with a maximal simplex. Then I have concluded that it is an n simplex. Therefore, x is pure dimension n. Okay. The third one. Recall what is third statement? Every n minus 1 simplex k occurs at the boundary of exactly 2 n simplexes. Like in a triangulation of a circle, every point, every vertex is incident exactly 2 edges. Right? So the same thing occurs in other dimension is what we have to prove. Okay. So take an n minus 1 simplex. This f is now n minus 1 simplex. Okay. Then for any point in the interior of f, what happens? From 1 we get z is isomorphic to hn of x minus x. We know this is because x is a manifold of dimension n. But this is, if you put the lemma there, it will be equal to h naught twiddle of link of f. I minus dimension of f minus 1. So dimension of f is n minus 1. N minus 1 minus 1 is just 0. Okay. So h naught twiddle of link of f. If the twiddle of link of f is z, remember, the h naught twiddle we have always computed. H naught twiddle for a connected space is 0. Okay. In fact, h naught and h naught twiddle differ by exactly one infinite cyclic component. So if h naught twiddle itself is z, this means that there are two components here. What is link of f when f is an n minus 1 simplex? It is just the number of vertices. Because there cannot be anything more than n simplex, because we have already proved that k is pure of dimension n. So f union u must be a simplex, and disjoint u must be not a point of f itself. Therefore, all these u form just a what set of vertices. Then, and its homology is reduced homology is z means. There are exactly two elements. Okay. So dimension of M is n minus 1, link of F is a vertex at VI, which is in 1-1 correspondence with n simplexes G of K such that F union VI is GI. So how many VIs are there? There are only two of them. Therefore, G eyes are exactly two of them, and F is a common face of them. Okay, let us prove the fourth statement now. Okay, on the set of all n simplexes having a chain from one to the other is an equivalence relation, just like two points can be connected by an edge path. Then if there is a path from here to here, there is a path from there to here, here to there, there to here, A to B, B to C, then there will be a path from A to C. Right? So this is an equivalence relation. We need to show that there is just one equivalence class. That means any two of them can be joined. Okay. Assuming on the contrary, let A be the subcomplex spanned by all n simplexes in one of the equivalence class. Start with one simplex. Then look at all the simplexes which can be joined to this simplex through a sequence of simplexes. Okay? You take that. So, it is not the whole space. Then what happens is a question, right? We need to show that there is just one equivalence class. Assuming in the contrary, let A be the subcomplex spanned by all n simplexes in one equivalence class. And B be the subcomplex spanned by the rest of them. So you have two subcomplexes which cover the entire K. Okay. Then mod A and mod B are closed subspaces of X because they are subcomplexes. X is connected. Therefore, intersection A, mod A, mod B, as well as A intersection B must be non-empty. A subcomplex itself is non-empty, otherwise A intersection B, mod A will not be intersecting. Okay? Alright, A and B are subcomplexes. A intersection B itself is subcomplex, which is non-empty. Okay? So far we are fine. Now, let F be a maximal simplex of A intersection B. This may be a single point or an edge or a triangle, you don't know. Okay, take the maximal simplex. It follows that dimension of F cannot be n. It must be smaller than n. Why? If it is n simplex, that will belong to both A and B. Right? So that is not possible. If it belongs to A, then it can be in that equivalence class. Okay. So, but B consists of those simplexes which are not connected to A. So, it must be a smaller thing. Not only that, if it is an N simplex, N minus 1 simplex, that means on this side there is an N simplex, and that side another N simplex, that means the class of A goes beyond A. So it cannot be even n minus 1. So it must be smaller than n minus 1. Okay. Alright. This implies that the link of F in K, okay, must be higher dimension than 0. If it's n minus 1 dimension, the link will be 0 dimension. If it is n dimension, link will be empty. If it is lower than, then only link will be of higher dimension, because the formula is dimension of F plus link of F plus 1 is equal to n. So link of F, the dimension of the link of F is positive, which means it is a simplicial complex of dimension greater than or equal to 1. That is the meaning of this. Okay. So, but the part 1 says that H naught twiddle of link of F must be 0 then. Okay. H naught twiddle of link of F is 0, and hence link of F is connected. It is positive dimension. By part 1, H naught twiddle is 0. And hence, link is connected. Link of F is connected inside F. Okay. Clearly, link of F cannot be inside, just inside A. By the very definition. Okay. Nor inside B. Okay. Link of F intersection A is non-empty. Link of F intersection B is also non-empty. From the maximality of F, which is very important now, inside A intersection B. Okay. I am not taking maximality inside the whole of K. But in A intersection B, it's a maximal simplex. Okay. Maximality of inside A intersection B, it follows that there is an edge E from link of F. This link of F has an edge. Now, I am taking with one vertex inside U, so one vertex U inside A minus B and the other vertex inside B, like that. Okay. So A start with U inside A minus B and another vertex V inside B minus A. So one vertex of A and one vertex of B should be joined by an edge which is inside F. So probably here you should make a picture of a two-dimensional simplicial complex. That's all you can do. Picture, you can make only two-dimensional simplicial complex. Okay, otherwise forcefully, this is pure set theory. You will have to see this one. A link of F, what we have proved, is connected. And this part and that part are both non-empty. So I take some part here, some vertex here, some vertex here, and they must be able to join. You must be able to join them inside link of F. So that may be a path. So along the path, you keep moving till you come to the last point in link of F, intersection A, and then jump to intersection B part. And that is the edge which will be, first vertex will be inside A, and the second vertex will be inside B. You understand how you can prove this one? Okay. So if S is a simplex, n simplex, such that F union E is contained inside S. Okay. Why I can do this one? Because K is a pure of dimension N. So every simplex is contained in a N simplex. Okay, so choose that as S here is an N simplex which contains E. Okay, actually F union E must be inside S because E is in the link of F. Anything in the link of F by definition, the union must be a face. F union E must be a simplex of K. So it is contained inside an N simplex. So it is contained in some other simplex. Then either this S is in A or in B, because all the simplexes, N simplexes have been divided. Those which are in one class, A, and other which are not in that class. So where it is either in A or in B. Okay? So that is a contradiction now, which implies both U and V are inside A or inside B. But I have chosen U and V. One is inside A, one is inside B. Actually, one is not in B and the other one is not in A is important here. Okay. So this is a very neat proof which I myself enjoy this one. So it is a simple-minded thing like this. You can, instead of edge path, you can have a path of simplexes. It's something very, very peculiar. And this property of a triangulated manifold itself is made into an axiom. And things which satisfy such an axiom are called pseudo-manifolds. I think we will stop here today. So next time we will study what is a pseudo-manifold. Based on this result. Okay. Thank you.